The ThingStack is an open source LoRaWAN network server for communicating with low power wireless devices. Today, I'm going to show you how to install the ThingStack Enterprise or open source on your own hardware in 5 minutes. Let's go. All of the instructions I'm following today are available in our documentation under Getting Started Installing the ThingStack. So what we need today is a machine running Docker and Docker Compose, DNS records pointing to that server, and a license if you're running Enterprise. Open source requires no license, so you can skip that step. Let's head over to configuration. To install the ThingStack, we need two files, Docker Compose and a TTN LWStack Docker configuration file. In the documentation, we describe what all the settings are in those files, and we also provide examples. So let's download those. This guide assumes the following working configuration. So I'll go ahead and create this file structure now, and then we can download the files. Docker Compose goes in the root. And TTN LWStack Docker goes in our config/stack folder. Let's check. Our files look good. The Docker Compose file instructs Docker to spin up a Postgres database, Redis, and finally the ThingStack. For development, we can run Docker Compose without changing the example. But if you're running it in production, you're going to want to find a working version of Postgres, Redis, and the ThingStack, and then to save the tags for those in that Docker Compose file. That way, every time you run it, you know you have exactly the same versions of all those applications. For this example, we'll leave it how it is. Oh, and definitely make sure you've opened ports 80 and 443 to your machine so you can get HTTPS connections into it. Now, let's take a look at TTN LWStack Docker. This file contains configuration for all the components of the ThingStack. We can start by entering our license key if we're running Enterprise. Leave it blank for open source. I'm running Enterprise, but I've already entered my license key using an environment variable. There's more information about that in our docs. Next, we want to make sure that we replace the example server in this file with our actual server address. We'll take all instances of the things.example.com and replace them with our real server address. Next, we configure email settings so that the ThingStack can send emails. This is necessary for things like forgot your password emails and for reviewing users. The TLS section is really important for HTTPS access. By default, we use ACME, which is built into the ThingStack to retrieve certificates for your domain. Configure the email address that you want to register that certificate under, and then make sure that your hosts and default host both represent your actual server address. To grant access to the console, and also to the NOC if you're running Enterprise, you'll want to update the client secrets in the NOC and console sections. You'll use these client secrets in the next step when you register the NOC and console as OAuth clients. For now, I'll leave the defaults, which are console and NOC. And that's all the configuration we need to change in TTN LWStack Docker to run in development. In production, you should also add HTTP keys and multi-tenancy keys. Check the docs for more information about how those work. Now, let's move on to certificates. Since we're using the built-in ACME support to retrieve certificates, all we need to do is create a folder so that it can store those certificates. Let's use the commands in the documentation. And the ACME folder is created. Now we can move on to running the ThingStack. Here, we just need to follow the commands in the documentation. First, we do a Docker Compose pull to grab all of the images that are defined in our Docker Compose file. Next, we initialize the IIS database. Then we'll initialize the application server database. And then the NOC database. And finally, we create our first tenant. These instructions just cover single tenant installations, but the ThingStack needs you to create a default tenant to work behind the scenes. If you're actually interested in multi-tenant installations, reach out to us for help. So go ahead and run that and create your first tenant. And then we want to create an admin user to log into that tenant. Here, you'll probably want to update your ID and definitely your email address. I'll just leave them as the examples. Set a strong password. And now it's time to register OAuth clients. First, we'll register the CLI. Then we'll register the console. And since I left all the configuration settings as the default, these default settings here are correct. I just need to update the server address. I'll go ahead and define my server address variable. And then the rest I can just copy and paste. In your case, make sure that you replace these with the values that you actually set in TTN LWStack Docker. Now let's do the knock. And now we're ready to run the ThingStack. Docker Compose up. And it's running. Let's go and check that domain. And the first time we access it, Acme needs some time to request the certificate, so it will take a little longer. And finally, we should be in. Now, we can log into the ThingStack using the password created, and there we are. The ThingStack is up and running on your own hardware. I hope that was helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us using the links below. Thanks for watching.